And we thank you very much for your attention. Good afternoon. My name is Paola Turina from the University of Bologna. I am presenting the Thermoscan algorithm, which is a text mining approach for the identification of thermodynamic data on protein folding from full text articles. Our main goal was to increase the size of the data sets used for training the predictor algorithms of protein folding stability and of the related mutation-induced changes. These two parameters are indicated by delta G and delta delta G, respectively. To reach this goal, we needed a tool for speeding up the selection of the right articles among the huge number of articles in PubMed, which, as you know, is the main database of biomedical literature. We started from an already existing data set of thermodynamic data on protein folding called ProTherm, updated up to the year 2010 and containing 1800 PubMed articles. First of all, we applied the tools of natural language processing to analyze the words occurrence in these 1800 abstracts. The next most frequent words were the three most frequent words were protein, stability, and unfolding, PSU for short. We started then from these three words for searching the abstract collection of PubMed. We also restricted the search to full text articles and to a time range not overlapping the ProTherm dataset. By that, we retrieved on the order of 300 articles. By manual screening of these 300 articles, we found that only about 2/3 of them did contain the target data. It was at this point that we recognized the need to devise a more selective text processing tool. So we took these positive and negative articles as our testing datasets. As training datasets, we took articles from ProTherm as the positive items, and as negative items, we retrieved articles from PubMed, which would resemble the negatives of our testing datasets. So we used the same PSU keywords for searching abstract, but restricting to a different time range. So after the training phase, we performed the blind prediction on our testing dataset. And okay, before we go on, let's have a look at the core of this automatic classification. And at the core are a few regular expressions. We search for four classes of words, namely thermodynamic concept, common thermodynamic parameters, unit of measure for thermodynamic parameters, words referring to computational studies. The first three classes increase the score, while the last class decreases it, since these words tend to occur more often in articles containing simulated data rather than experimental ones. The score is calculated for each paragraph of the scannerized article. Examples of thermodynamic concepts are the words to state, unfolding, the nature, and so on. Common thermodynamic parameters are, for instance, heat capacity, melting temperature, delta G. Then we have the unit of measures, and the words typically found in computational studies are simulation, molecular dynamics, for field, etc. Okay, so coming back to the comparison between the manual and the automatic classification, we evaluated the performance of Thermoscan, as usual for a binary classification, by calculating the confusion matrix. As usual, we have the so-called true positive and true negatives. The true positives are, in this case, those articles containing quantitative thermodynamic data on protein folding. Then we have the false positive and the false negatives. The performance values varied, of course, as a function of where the threshold is set. So in the next slide, you can see how the threshold was optimized. Recall and precision values are plotted here as a function of the threshold for the paragraph score. In particular, in this case, we took for each article the maximum paragraph score found in the whole article. And as you can see, the threshold which optimizes both recall and precision can be set around 3. We also drew a similar plot for taking as paragraph score the mean across all paragraph scores of a given article. However, the best scoring system turned out to be the maximum paragraph score. So, in the next slide, we show some of the performance measures calculated for Thermoscan given the optimized threshold, namely the overall accuracy, the Matthews correlation coefficient, and the area under the rock curve. You can see that this performance value score relatively high for Thermoscan. For comparison, on the same testing sets, we apply two other text mining methods, namely the Medline Ranker and the BioReader. They both scored lower than Thermoscan. In particular, the Matthews correlation coefficient scored on average twofold higher for Thermoscan than for the other two methods. It is to be noted that both Medline Ranker and BioReader also use training datasets, but are devised for general document classification and analyze only the abstracts. So in conclusion, we can tell that Thermoscan identifies the target articles with good precision, and that keys to the good performance of Thermoscan appear to be that it makes use of the full text and that the applied regular expressions focus on words which are highly characterizing for the field of interest. In perspective, we await from Thermoscan a great help in scaling up the existing databases of delta G and delta delta G values of protein stability. And we thank you very much for your attention.